Hi, my name is Liz Hubert. I'm a behavioral health consultant at Taiyi High School, working in the school-based health clinic program at HealthPoint. Today, I'd like to talk to you about a practice called grounding. So what grounding is, it's a practice that can help you to pull away from strong or challenging emotions and also from physical or emotional pain. Grounding techniques help to distract you from what you're experiencing and refocus on what's happening in the present moment. Often when we're having a strong emotion, it's usually when we're thinking about something in the future or in the past. So grounding pulls us back into where we are in the current space and time, and it helps to calm us by distracting us by doing a simple activity. There are three different types of grounding techniques that I'll talk about today, and each one can be done any place, any time, which is one thing I really like about grounding. A few tips for using grounding. As I said, you can do it any place, any time. It can be helpful to practice these techniques before you're feeling super stressed or feeling really strong sensations, because you'll be more likely to access them when you are starting to feel upset or some strong emotions. When you're doing grounding, you keep your eyes open. You really are staying present in the present moment is what the whole idea behind grounding is. It can be helpful to rate your mood before and after doing a grounding activity just to see how well it worked for you. I always recommend to people to really try a lot of different types of grounding strategies. Some work better for some than others, and to really figure out what works best for you. And also the last thing is to kind of stay neutral while you're doing the grounding exercise. So avoid judgments of what's good or bad. For example, I'm going to give you an example of a grounding strategy where you're just naming things and you basically just say what they are. You don't have to make a judgment about what they are. So really what you're doing is you're trying to focus on the present, not the past or the future. So as I said, there's three different types of grounding that I'm going to talk about really briefly today. One is mental grounding. So mental grounding is a way to focus your mind. So one of my favorite mental grounding exercises is just to describe your environment in detail. So what I like to do is use my senses and think of five things I see, four things I hear, three things that I feel, two things I smell, and one thing that I taste. And that's the way that, that's a very simple and easy mental grounding strategy. A second mental grounding strategy is to just think of categories. So think of types of dogs, think of different sports that you can play. You can come up with a category and you just name them off either out loud or just in your mind. So those are a couple examples of mental grounding strategies. Physical grounding is a way to bring yourself back into your senses. And I like to think about physical grounding in terms of what I'm feeling. So an example would be just to dig your heels into the floor, push your back against the chair you're sitting in. You can keep a grounding object in your pocket, like a smooth rock, or maybe a soft piece of cloth that you just rub your fingers on when you're feeling getting a little stressed. Also just noticing your body in physical space, how you're sitting in the chair, just the weight of yourself in your chair on the floor. Another type of physical grounding that I like is to clench and unclench my fists or curl my toes in the carpet where I'm sitting. So those are just some ideas of some things to do for physical grounding. And the third category of grounding is soothing grounding. So with soothing grounding, you're kind of doing some positive self-talk. You're saying kind statements to yourself, things like, you can get through this. I believe in you. Another way to do some soothing grounding is to picture a place or people that you really care about, and really think about, notice the feelings that come up when you think about that happy place or those people that you really love. Another thing that you can do is look forward to a trip that's coming up or another fun thing that you might be doing in the future. So those are all soothing grounding strategies. So as I said, physical, mental, and soothing grounding. Give them a shot, see what you think. Do some more Googling if you want some more information on this topic. And I give permission for my recording to be shared. Thank you.